experts or the innovators that we talked to earlier. Do you want to have a flat organization where you want to have everybody try every job, knowing that not everybody's going to be an innovator?
No, you have to let people do what they know how to do. What I object to about companies is they don't tend to hire innovators in the first place. They're not sitting there thinking, how can I get some brilliant guys who are kind of going to be really annoying and dress funny and wear a dress, as Vinod said, and actually maybe come up with something really great, but it won't be for 10 years. Will they ask that? Will they let that happen?
Yeah, Vinod was a tremendous innovator. Didn't
oh,
you think?
Yeah.
He had so many great ideas.
And he's always had great ideas. And I love that he's a venture capitalist, because venture capitalists are the big killers of ideas, and maybe he's actually not doing that.
Does the innovation start at the top with the CEO?
No, it's the only thing the CEO does is let you feel like you have the right to voice your idea.
Howard said it did start at the top. Howard Putnam.
Probably in his company it did, because what happened in Southwest was Southwest was a brilliant idea, started by a brilliant guy. That's wonderful when that happens. But if I'm running a company and I want to start innovating, I don't want to say to the CEO, hey, look, CEO, your job is to have the ideas. That's never happening. The only thing a CEO is supposed to do is to let people have ideas. Let people come up with a tough question and not get angry about it and say, well, yeah, that's hard. I'm confused. That's great. I love being confused.
It was a great discussion, Roger. I really, really enjoyed tonight, and I am so looking forward to next week.
Me too.
I'll see you then, Roger Schenk. That's the business of innovation for this week. I'm Maria Bartiromo. Now here's a look at what's ahead on next week's program.
New management will never make a company change in an important way. It'll make it more efficient, it'll make it more profitable, but it'll never make it change.
Evolution and revolution. The challenge to look inside your business for opportunities versus the chance to hit the jackpot with something totally new.
This place is wrong. It ain't working right.
That's next week on The Business of Innovation. And for more information on our programs, go to innovation.cnbc.com for videos, transcripts, and more.
Southwest was a beacon of innovation and profitability.
One way that we found was important is we had no AEE, no arrogance, no ego, no exclusion. It's just a pretty humble organization so that everybody could participate.
But didn't you say earlier, too, that, I mean, people had fun. You wanted your flight attendants to look like they were having fun.
And they did.
Yeah.
Still do.
In our case, we have no offices. We sit in desks with one another. You get rid of titles. You get rid of a lot of things that basically inhibit the kind of corporate arrogance or the idea that you can rest on yesterday's success.
Well, you get fired if you're really annoying. Creative people are really annoying. So I want to know, if I was working for you, would I get fired because I'm really annoying?
It would really depend how annoying you really are, Howard.
That was Roger, actually.
Don't blame Howard.
Let's put it, I think there's a real good place for constructive annoyance, okay?